Hello, years 5 and 6, and welcome to Tuesday's English lesson. I hope you're all well and that you've been enjoying some of the snow. I just wanted to say a big thank you to those of you that have already completed the Reading for Pleasure survey. If you haven't already, please, 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 could you click on the link that will be on your blog and complete the survey? It won't take long to do. And if you take part, then you will be entered into a draw with a chance of winning a £10 book token.
Okay, so let's get on with today's lesson then. So Tuesday, the 9th of February today, and your learning intention is, can I punctuate my dialogue correctly? Now, I know you will have done dialogue a lot with your teachers over the last few years. However, children still make errors when they are writing narratives or newspaper articles with the punctuation of direct speech. So let's do this as a bit of revision today. Okay, so here is some dialogue. I'd like you to pause the video and have a look at this dialogue and see if you can come up with a list of rules for when you are writing dialogue in narratives or newspaper articles. Okay, welcome back. So hopefully you notice that we need inverted commas. I'll use my arrow here. Inverted commas at the start and end of a piece of dialogue. We also need another form of punctuation before the closing inverted commas, don't we? So this example here, this person has exclaimed, so we've got an exclamation mark. We might have a question mark if they've asked a question. Otherwise, we tend to use commas. So there's a comma here, all the others have commas. Okay, this example though, because we've got the dialogue as the last thing, then we've got a full stop because that signals the end, and here also. But otherwise, you would generally use a comma if you're then going to follow it with who said it. Okay, the other thing you should have noticed, hopefully, we've got two different people speaking here. We've got the firefighter and we've got Miss Carlia. Okay, and each time a different person speaks, we're using a new line. It's not just when somebody new, completely new, speaks. It's when a different person speaks. Okay, so every time the person speaking changes, we start a new paragraph. Okay, if you have a look in your, if you're reading a fiction book at the moment, I'm sure if you have a look, you will see how that works in that. Okay, at the start of what the person is saying, obviously I, as a pronoun, needs a capital letter anyway, but you also notice the P is capital, as is the D. Okay, and the T in thank you. So when it's the first thing that the person is saying, you need a capital letter. But you will notice here that in this example, we don't have a capital letter for my, because it's a continuation of this piece of dialogue. Please help, my cat is still in the house. So it's a continuation. When you sort of put begged Miss Carly and then continue what that person is saying, you don't need that capital letter. But you do need a comma here, look, after Miss Carly before you have your opening inverted commas. Okay. And you will notice that I've tried really hard not to say said Miss Carlia or said the firefighter said, okay? So it's really good to vary. It's not wrong, like have you said here, but it's not wrong. It's better to try and vary it. So it really helps the reader, doesn't it, to understand how it's been said. Otherwise, if you just say said, it's not sure, but I can tell. I know how I said it because I've got the word relieved here in front of Miss Carlia. Okay. Okay, so hopefully you came up with the same list of rules, and if you didn't, then hopefully that's been a good reminder for what they are. The next thing I'd like you to do is look at this comic strip here, taken from Dennis the Menace. I think it's from the Beano comic, but anyway, it's an extract of a Dennis the Menace cartoon. I want you to convert that into a piece of narrative. So basically you're taking what they're saying in those speech bubbles and writing it how it would look in a story, and remember how you need to punctuate it. And then restart when you're ready to perhaps have a look at what I would write if it was me. Okay, so welcome back. I'm going to have a go at doing this. I've got the computer set up in a very awkward way with the iPad recording, so it might not go very well. But so the first thing is we've got Dennis asking, what am I doing here? So I need my open inverted commas, don't I? Start the speech, I need a capital letter. What, oops, am I doing here? And he asks a question, so I need a question mark in this instance, don't I? With closing inverted commas, asked. Note, I haven't used a capital letter for asked because I haven't finished, although a question mark signals the end of a sentence, this is not the end of my sentence with the dialogue. Asked Dennis. And I'm going to add in, I can't type today, an adverb there to show how he said it. So ask Dennis grumpily, he clearly doesn't want to be there. Now his mum is speaking. So his mum, I'm going to put this at the start, replied, a comma after that, before I have the opening inverted commas, you're here to help push the trolley. And here I'm going to put a full stop because that is the end of that sentence. Okay, now the next person to speak is Dennis, so I'm going to start another paragraph. So Dennis, open inverted commas, says, this is what me doing that looks like. And because I'm doing a piece of now, a comma before my closing inverted commas, argued, Dennis, laying on the floor in protest. So I'm adding a bit of narrative there to show that he's obviously not happy about being there. Okay, so I'm going to leave that there, and hopefully you, if you haven't already done it, you can carry on in the same way as that, and accurately punctuate your speech. Okay, so today's writing task is I want you to pick something from each column. So it might be that your setting is the garden shed, and you might have the queen as the character. The problem might be that there's a tornado, and perhaps that's why she's in the shed, sheltering from the tornado. And then positive words, so what might happen, maybe a unicorn appears. Oh, got unicorn twice on there. Unicorn appears to save the day. Don't know how I managed to do that twice, but anyway. So pick one thing from each of those, and then I want you to do a piece of writing based on those four things. So it could be, this really, the obvious thing would be to write a piece of narrative, so a story. But you could also write a diary entry, or perhaps a newspaper article. Bearing in mind though, don't include speech in a diary entry, because then it is more like a story. So anyway, you get to choose what text type you write. I hope you have fun writing it, and we look forward to reading what you come up with. Okay, speak to you soon, bye.